Hey, what's up guys, Keenan here, and in this video, I'm gonna talk about the training method that I typically use most of the time, and that is basically power building. So, this is what allows me to gain strength and gain size and muscularity at the same time. So basically what I do is, you've probably heard Mike O'Hearn talk about it, but you're gonna start your workout off lifting heavy and building your strength until you kind of get to, you start to get fatigued. You can feel yourself losing strength. So you'll do this with lower reps, higher weight. And as soon as you start getting fatigued and your strength drops, that's when you will drop the weight, increase the reps, and just kind of finish with like the burnout. And you'll do more accessory type workouts, isolating type workouts that will just basically chisel the muscles up. So today we're working on biceps. So I'm gonna start off with just warming up. So we're gonna start with barbell curls. This will allow us to do about as heavy weight as we can go. You could do this or you could use an easy bar, but you know, this is a good movement so that you can do heavy weight. So I will warm up just the bar. And another thing you want to keep in mind too, when you're doing kind of the power building, you don't want to be unsafe. So you don't want to put yourself at risk for injury. But you don't have to be super strict with your form in the power, in the heavier movements, because it's all about gaining strength and putting as much stress on your muscles as possible. You want your muscles to grow and get bigger. So you kind of have to do weight that your body's not used to, that you kind of can't do. So we will work our way up to that on these barbell curls. And basically, we're gonna get to the point where we might swing a little bit. We might add a little bit of movement in there to help us get the weight up. But the main focus is on the decline motion of the workout. You know, once you get that heavy weight up here, you're stronger on the way down, and you can really build muscle this way. So all right, we're kind of warmed up now. So I'm gonna put on 25.
So this is 95 pounds right now.
We're using an Olympic bar, so that's 45 pounds. 225, so we're at 95. So this is gonna be kind of heavy for me, but that's the point here, is we're just trying to go heavy and build muscle, get stronger. So we got 5 reps in on that. That's pretty close to the rep range that I like to stick to on these heavier movements. So we'll probably go about 5 sets on this heavier weight. We'll work our way up a little bit towards the end of the workout, add a little bit more weight on there. And we're really gonna push it on the last few sets. And then once we're pretty much worn out, our strength is starting to decline and go back down, we will then drop the weight and just start wrapping it out. Whew. So at this point in the workout, we're starting to lose our form. So I'm just focused on getting the weight up. So I will swing a little bit and cheat a little bit to get that weight up. But then I'm gonna strictly use my biceps to lower the weight, because otherwise I'm not gonna be able to get this weight up without cheating a little bit. I would rather do the heavier weight on the decline part of the workout than lower the weight right now and be able to do a strict rep. So this isn't something you want to always do, but this is what I'm doing right now during this power building exercise. So that's our fifth set. So time to drop the weight, increase the intensity, increase the reps. Now this is where I'm going to throw in supersets and things, because we're just trying to burn our biceps the rest of the way at this point. Okay, so we're going to grab a 20 pound dumbbell and just going to do some hammer curls. To help us finish this exercise and get that final burnout. So take about 30 to 45 seconds. Then we'll hit our next set. All right, guys, so that's pretty much the gist of power building. Start off heavy, cheat a little bit if you need to get that weight up, because you want to go as heavy as possible, heavier than what you normally could do, on the decline portion of the workout. And then once your strength starts to taper off and you start losing your strength, then it's time to just drop the weight, increase the reps, increase the intensity, and throw in some supersets and just finish tearing the muscle down. So at this point in the workout, the pump is pretty good. You know, you can see a pretty clear difference between now and before the workout started. And so the cool thing about power building is you can track your weight that you did in the beginning portion of the workout, so you know what to aim for next time you hit that muscle group. So you have a clear weight goal that you can hit, and then after that, you're just going to keep burning out. Your endurance is slowly going to increase, your strength will slowly increase, your muscle size will slowly increase. So all in all, it's a great way to just build strength and size at the same time. Now, if you want just strength or if you want just size, there might be a different way to go, but this is what I like to do. I like to be balanced and have decent strength and decent size at the same time. So if you're someone who has the same goals, hit power building and do this type of workout. So that's it for this video, guys. Thanks for watching. Catch you in the next one.